Just going around today, you hear sirens everywhere. Like, what's going on? I guess this explains it. Apparently last night, I guess there was another gang shooting of sort. Look at all the pictures that people uploaded with how many ambulance and police cars there were just around the area. And from the looks of it too, apparently a police SUV crashed into a bus. It seemed like the bus driver was in the right and the police officer was, I guess, in the wrong. Maybe they were rushing, trying to get to the scene, and then, oop, wrong side of the lane traffic, I guess. But like the other shootings, apparently they found a car being burned down as well. What's with all these gang shootings and stuff recently? It's just during these times. I actually don't remember a time when it's been this rampant overall. Not basically targeting the right sources and stuff, in my opinion, right? Focusing on the wrong stuff, probably, in terms of reducing all the violence. And with that thought of targeting the right sources and stuff in terms of criminal activities, this was kind of interesting in terms of, I guess, drone detection and stuff around airports. This one says, drone detection system keeping an eye on the skies at the Ottawa airport. There's actually a lot about this article that didn't make much sense, but it starts here by saying the Ottawa International Airport's new drone detection system identified more than 250 drones flying in illegal airspace near the airport this spring. So they're saying they partnered with all these companies to detect, I guess, what's flying around the area. And it says here, quote, "What we are seeing and reporting to Transport Canada is a very disturbing trend that requires a quick response to reverse the number of drone operators flying in restricted airspace," said Mark LaRoche, president of the Ottawa International Airport, about the early results of the pilot project. In March, 101 drone flights were detected within 5.6 kilometers of the airport, while there were 167 drone flights detected near the airport in April. A number of these were flown during hours of darkness and some exceeding altitudes of 1,600 feet. Transport Canada guidelines states it's illegal to fly a drone within 5.6 kilometers of any center of any airport in Canada. Anyone operating a drone that weighs over 260 grams must have a drone pilot certificate and only fly drones that are marked and registered. Okay, so many things wrong with that. As you guys know, for example, it should be under 250 grams. Without actual specific numbers and data, it could just be, for example, what if it was micro drones flying 5.5 kilometers and they're only flying maybe like 50 meters in the air or something like that, just to get some basic videos. I mean, technically, according to this anyways, that would count here as, oh no, too many drones around the area, even though technically that is perfectly legal. That's where it got interesting kind of reading this. It says, the YOW drone detection pilot program is using two types of technology, radio frequency detection and micro Doppler radar. The RF drone detection can detect drones operating on 2.4 and 5.8 gigahertz within a 15 kilometer radius and can determine the make and size of the device. The system includes a user interface that provides real-time and consolidated historical reports, including drone ID numbers in most cases. It says in March, the RF drone detection provided by Indra Robotics detected 1,626 flights within the 15-kilometer zone. Micro Doppler radar uses millimetric wave radar to detect the movement of the small spinning propellers on a drone flying within 2 kilometers of the airport. Now, why that's confusing is if you say you can detect every single thing that's flying up there, in this case, if you say that what they're doing is illegal and all that, like people flying, I don't know, like say a huge drone or something like that in the controlled airspace without permission, why don't you just go there and I guess approach them, find them or whatever? Because again, it should just come down to then treat it as an incident. You take care of whoever you think is a troublemaker. Because it says here, the airport says on March 15th, a privately operated drone took an unauthorized 11-minute flight just north of the airfield at Ottawa International Airport. The same drone flew 24 flights during March, including flights close to the Civic Hospital Air Ambulance Helipad and CHEO Helipad and Parliament Hill. And they say here, quote, "We know what type of drone it was. Its unique ID number, its flight time, flight path, and its maximum altitude. It should not have been flying in any of those locations, and in doing so was in violation of Transport Canada regulations." That doesn't make sense to me again. You have all this data, you're kind of claiming you know exactly where they are, what they were doing, all these flights. So why didn't you stop them? That doesn't make sense to me, does it? It's almost like someone saying, okay, we know exactly where these gangsters are. We know exactly the car path that they took. We can see you exactly when and where. If that's the case, then why don't you arrest them or something? I don't get it. Does that make sense? It sounds like it's more as an excuse just to potentially create more over-the-top restrictions that doesn't make sense for the mass majority, by the sounds of it anyways. because this other story I read actually related with things like drones and stuff too, but it actually unfortunately dealt with deaths, in this case a lot of kids. It was actually a big story around here where apparently they found in a residential school there was like over 200 dead bodies of kids buried, I guess, around that school area. And I guess because of that, a lot of media, they're actually going there taking pictures, photos. But because of that too, apparently Transport Canada issued a NOTAM banning any flights around the area. As they said in the post here, this says they're restricting all air traffic up to 500 feet above ground, including drones, in the Kamloops Indian Residential School area. And you can see in the actual NOTAM reports here, that was kind of the interesting thing. And it says here, no person shall operate OPR and ACFT, including remotely piloted ACFT, RPA drone, and model ACFT within the area described. So it's basically things like a model aircraft too. And reading the comments, for example, like this person says, how does issuing this particular NOTAM help? And this person says, out of respect for the survivors. And then if you keep going down, I believe there's one person here who says, keep weirdos with cameras on their drones away. So again, the assumption is everyone thinks a quote drone is the exact same thing, like let's just say DJI drone or something like that. They don't factor everything that this thing actually regulates in such a broad way. Like in this case too, since it's so broad, wouldn't it just be more of a common sense, I guess, public service announcement saying, okay, we know people want to, I guess, find out what's going on here. They may want to take videos and stuff, but out of respect and privacy for the family, please give them that privacy. Isn't that all you really need to do? Because I would imagine here in terms of like privacy, someone could just literally walk up with their news camera or some of that, their smartphone, and start taping everything, right? Like drone or not. So what's the difference? Or a kite. Correct? You can actually take a kite, fly it up in the air with a camera or something like that, so it would be the same thing. So that doesn't really solve that issue of, I guess, quote, privacy overall. It's more about having that common sense, isn't it? But with all that, just bringing everything together, I mean, I think all these stories have one thing in common, I guess. People just aren't focused on the right things that are actually safety issues, and people are dying. Instead, you're basically worried in many ways of, oh no, the person flying like a toy drone or something like that, someone just flying it quickly to get like a video or a picture, that's it. That is your big concern. Not like this, when there's like people dying in these ways that aren't being, I guess, dealt with appropriately. Doesn't make sense, huh? Thank you. Alright, see you guys later.